Listen to your favorite morning show on the Tracy's Collision Cam.
Every morning.
Just head over to Facebook. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
We have three guests at the radio station, all in the green room. We've taken away their phones, any type of electronics, so they can't hear the show. Because we're live on the Tracy's Collision Cam. Can't let them see what we have in the box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning. It's a competition. Timed event. Each of them will get 60 seconds in the box and figure out what's in it. We're going to oversell the fact that they could get hurt this morning. And which really is not a possibility. But they're going to feel like it. And you're going to hear us repeatedly say that they could get bit. And that's where I think the genius thing of this whole operation lies. And if it weren't for you going and getting these, you did a lot of work on this.
Grandma Cindy got the hookup.
Thank you, Grandma Cindy.
And these are not Grandma Cindy's, by the way. Maybe I should make that known.
We're going to go ahead and tell you now what's in the box. And then they can't hear us. And then we're going to bring them in one at a time. We have Becky, Loverboy, and Nicole. Each of them will come in one at a time and get an opportunity to put their hands in the box. What is in the box this morning came from a dead person. That is the truth. Mm-hmm. They're no longer with us. R.I.P. Mary. These are her upper shelf, it looks like. These are uppers, aren't they?
These are uppers. I hope she wore them uppers. They look really weird downers.
These are her teeth. We have got dentures from a dead lady in the box this morning that they're going to have to. And I think, again, we're going to tell them that they could get bit. And they could. If Mary were still alive, she could bite them. Sure. Put your fingers in somebody's mouth. That's what's going to happen.
Listen, they could be haunted. We don't know.
We don't know. So the question is this, what do we take as an answer? Teeth? I think teeth, right? I mean, the answer is dentures. Do they have to say dentures or can they say teeth?
Oh, that's a great point. I say we'll see how it goes. We'll see when they say teeth and see when they say dentures. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So if no one says dentures, then we'll base it on teeth.
So there is a particular answer that we're looking for, right? Which is dentures.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ultimately, we're looking for dentures. So if only one person says dentures out of the three of them, then that person wins.
I don't know, but it's not what I thought it would look like, dentures. Like, my grandma had them, and she'd plop them out and put them in a glass of water next to her bed.
That looks exactly what they would look like to me.
The gums, though? I guess I didn't realize the gums went so high.
Maybe Mary wanted some high gums.
That's not a good look, is it?
Well, I don't know. Some people like it.
All right, well, when we come back, Becky will be our first guest to try to figure out what's in the box, which again this morning is dentures from a dead lady who passed. We don't know when, but they are her teeth. And Becky will try to figure that out when we come back.
Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise.
You're listening to Gary and Johanna in the morning on Froggy.
I don't know. Yeah, give me 1 second. So those monitors are off, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotta turn mine off too.
Okay, are there headphones over there for him? They should be. Those headphones should be over there because we're going to need to wear them probably. Do you know how loud they are, Johanna? Those headphones? Hello, 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 hello. Normal loud?
I think so.
Okay.
Mine are louder.
Yeah, they're. Why we're all not on? Oh, we ended up being on the cam. Yes, how are you feeling today, Gary? Did you go? I go to the doctor today. Yeah, I think we play a song, so we'll go get her when this song is playing. When this first song is playing. Kenny, I know you're working the controls back there. Are you going to be able to help us with the time? Are you going to do that, Johanna?
I can do it.
Okay, never mind. Johanna got it.
I'll do it.
Now, Loverboy's been trying to get on the air forever. Let's see if he clams up or not when he gets on here for you, or if he does he entertain. Oh. They haven't shown you the teeth yet. We're going to do that when we bring her in. Where is Kyle Nay? That's a good question. We don't know. He's in Nashville, and he ghosted us yesterday. Becky, what time you get on your plane? That's not the Becky we have in here.
No.
Kenny, did you figure out a way? No, he did not, Terry. He did not contact us yesterday.
No. He's in hot water
right
now.
He's in big trouble, for real.
He's in big trouble.
Hey, were you able to put up anything, Kenny? Figure that out or no? Or you can't, Kenny, because it's on Zoom.
Wait. Hold on.
Don't stress him out. I don't want him.
He's working back there.
I know, but I just don't want him stressed out.
Okay, I got it.
Are you serious? K-Lion's about to be real butthurt when we steal you.
Oh, butthurt for real.
Okay, I got it.
Kenny, do you think you can just go grab Becky real quick and bring her in?
Yeah. Do you know which one's Becky?
No, but
you can just say, hey, Becky, and she'll answer.
Yeah. That's a good point.
Hopefully everything's okay. Well, yeah, everything's okay with the Deborah. I saw pictures. He's partying it up. He's having the time of his life.
He's having a great old time.
Nobody kidnapped him. He's fine. We're not calling Kyle. Actually, I need to stop talking about him.
Yeah, you better stop.
He's like married to me. Yeah.
He's like...
Hi. Come on
That's
over
really
here.
That's really jacked up. Hi. Are you excited?
Oh, my God. I'm so nervous for you.
This is great for everybody on the cam, fam. Yeah,
so what you're going to do is put those headphones on, okay? We're going to give you instructions in just a minute. But really, it's pretty simple. You're going to put your hands in the box and you're going to tell us what it is.
You want to be the first to tell us what it is. So you can shout out answers.
Please do. Talk as you're
feeling. Talk as you're feeling.
Try to figure it out.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Footprints in the sand. Cold walk in December, warming up your hands.
The Tracy's Collision Cam is live. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
What's in the box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning? Join us now on the Tracy's Collision Cam. We have Becky. Becky is the first of three contestants who's going to put her hands in the box. She just pulled what? Johanna, what did she just pull out?
She just pulled gloves out of her pocket.
You know you can't wear gloves, Becky.
So,
I tried, though.
She came with jokes, though. I love it.
I know. Grab the microphone, Becky.
Oh, yeah, bring it down a little bit.
You
got
to put it really close to your mouth. Face. Okay?
You can probably pull the whole thing down if you want to.
Yeah, just yank that whole thing over next to you.
Oh.
Yeah, don't disturb what's in the box, please.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Sleeping?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, no, it's not my husband.
Becky, have you seen any of these What's in the Box? Have you?
Oh, yes.
Yeah? Which one was your favorite? We've done a ton of these.
Oh. I don't really have a favorite.
You don't?
No.
Yeah.
I just felt sorry for everybody that did it.
And you still agreed
and
to do this.
Yeah, all the way from Fairbury. How's that?
Yeah, we got a traveler on our hands.
Let's give you the rules here, Becky. Right. They're simple. There's a box in front of you. Everybody knows what's in the box, and they can see what's in the box now. If you missed it, we told them a minute ago.
Mm-hmm.
But if they weren't listening, they can go and see that on the Tracy's Collision Cam. You have to figure out what's in it. We give you 60 seconds. And it's timed. As soon as you say what we're looking for, there's a particular thing that we're looking for you to say. That is where your time will be. If yours is the fastest amongst the other two listeners that we have, then you're going to win concert tickets this morning.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
Now, there's something we need to tell you.
Yes. What's that, Gary?
It could be dangerous this morning when you stick your hands in there.
Oh, thanks. I got to go back to work, you know.
I know.
I use my fingers.
I know. Well, that's where we We were supposed to have you sign a waiver this morning, and that's for real. Uh-huh. We did not get that done. Mm-hmm. So because I know management, I know Penthouse Amy is a big listener of the show, so mm-hmm. is Earrings. We need you to do a verbal waiver if you could. Okay. Would you be willing to do that for us?
Sure.
Okay, can you please raise your right hand? Raise your right hand and say, I swear.
I swear.
I, Becky.
I, Becky.
I swear.
I swear.
Not to sue the radio station.
Not to... sue the radio station.
If
just
I,
Gary.
If I, it's her fault. First of all,
why is
don't
it my
become
fault?
Suing me.
Because you're the one that got it. You have connections.
Yeah, but he
that's
had
right.
the idea. He had the idea. I oh. have. Yeah.
I didn't okay. finish it. I will not sue the radio station if I get bit.
If I get bit.
Okay, that's all we needed. Are you ready to stick your hands in the box? We're going to put 60 seconds on the box. When you hear, you'll hear it count down 3, 2, 1. As soon as you hear okay. one, get your hands in there. And again, this is timed.
I know.
So feel around and don't be quiet. Whatever you think it is, just start saying something, okay?
Okay.
Johanna, are you ready with the timer?
Yep.
All right, it is time for Becky and What's in the Box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Your hands in there, Becky. Start feeling around. What does it feel like?
Heck.
Becky, what does it feel like?
I don't know. It feels like a rock. It feels like...
Pick it up. Don't be scared. What is it?
Teeth?
Teeth?
Yeah. Like dentures?
Dentures.
Oh.
That's
nice.
What we're looking for. That's time. Yes.
Yes.
They're that's dentures from a dead person, a they're, real live dead
oh,
person.
Mary. Her name's Mary. R.I.P.
We need to thank Mary for her teeth. Thank you, Mary. She took care of them.
Yeah, they actually don't look that bad. They're a little like janky, like wonky looking, but.
What was her time?
She said dentures in 24 seconds.
24 seconds. That's a pretty good time. Yeah.
Very good, but okay.
Yes, that is. That's really good.
Yeah, yeah. So that's something that right now you're on the leaderboard. When you go back in there, act scared and act like something bit you.
We've had people in the past go to the bathroom, vigorously wash their hands, maybe grab some hand sanitizer.
Yeah. I'll put this on.
Act really grossed out. Yeah.
Yeah, put your gloves on.
Oh,
yeah,
there you
absolutely.
Go. That's perfect. Because you want them to be scared to touch it.
Yeah.
All right, Becky.
I'm supposed to do a shout out to Javi.
Oh, of course.
We're going to bring on Loverboy next. We'll see how well he does when he puts his hands in the box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
I think we need a little
Gary and Johanna in the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I cannot believe them.
I cannot
They're
believe
disgusting.
They put that in the box.
There you go. You know.
I love it.
Hi, Gary. Finally. Nice to meet you.
I know.
You've never met Gary?
No.
Oh, my gosh.
Poor, see my ribs seeing me yesterday. They're popping in and out.
Hey, you look really sad.
I know. And she does not care for me at all. Right. She's a terrible caretaker.
I didn't sign up. He told me none of that stuff works. I offered to bring
Bile Freeze. I don't know if it works or not.
He's like, it's cartilage. It's cartilage.
Wow. Let's see the doctor today.
It's for everybody, you know, like all your muscles.
I know it.
I know.
We'll bring you in when Nicole is going, you and Loverboy will come back in here.
Okay.
And then we'll tell everybody who the winner is. Don't share your time.
No.
Don't tell them what it was. Okay? Yeah. All right. Nice work, Becky. Thank you. She likes a cold brew.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. We're going to play a song, and then we'll bring on Loverboy. Okay.
Don't you feel like this is the one thing about having listeners in?
Yeah.
They really make us look like wussies.
Yeah. Yeah, but she's not touching
know,
a dead rabbit.
I know,
okay.
But she doesn't know that.
No. No.
I wonder if it would have been different, if it'd be different for us if we did a time frame and stuff.
You know what we should put on it? I didn't even think about it.
What?
What's the stuff that the...
Oh, we forgot about the...
I know, but what we should have put is that the stuff that they've used to thicken in there. You put it.
Would it stick to your hands?
Joanna, no. You know, they don't stick them in there. They have to put this gel in it, and it's like glue. It sticks them to their gums.
We should have done that.
Gums stick to gums.
Is that glue, though?
No. I can't remember what it's called. Somebody on here got false teeth. What is that called? Denture cream? No. Yeah, I brought this wrap this morning because it already popped out of me one time. Joanna said, I can't disturb the show anymore. Nate says your hair is cute. Fix it in. Is that right?
That sounds right.
Yeah. We should put some fix it in there.
You're the one with all the trashy family.
So only trash people got fake false teeth.
No, I know people with fake teeth that aren't trashy.
Polygrip, that's another
one. Don't you feel like a lot of people from Missouri probably
Who don't take care of the teeth. Yes, I had a lot. For sure.
I'm going to give you one of these.
I'm not chewing it.
I just want to do this. Look at this. It comes with papers. I don't understand because you still have to touch it.
It's so gross.
To give you your piece of gum. There you go.
I'll chew it later. That's a piece of gum. Joanna got all natural gum. It looks like chalk.
Guys, it tastes like all natural gum. It ain't good. I'll be the first to tell you it's not good gum. It looks like rabbit poop.
I don't think Loverboy's going to beat that time. We think, Joe.
What? You think Loverboy's going to be our favorite?
No.
What? What'd you say?
I said, I don't think he's going to beat that time.
Oh. I'm interested to see if he's scared or not, because he's been saying, like, get me on What's in the Box.
Yeah.
I can't see anyone on my monitor, so I have to stare you over.
I'm going to lie and tell him that it bit Becky. Did she tell you it bit her?
Yeah, you should.
Landon, can you say hi to me? 24 seconds was Becky's time.
I'm feeling like short today.
That's because I'm high up in my chair, maybe.
Really?
Maybe.
Gary is gross. Why?
I don't know why Sam say that, because I backed up on him probably still. Everybody says your makeup is on point. Your hair is perfect.
It is not. Today is like I'm very thankful. Thank you for saying that. Makes me feel good.
Kenny, do you mind getting Loverboy?
I have to put on lipstick because I got the cold sores.
Nobody
said
anything
about it. Got the herp I gave
it.
My husband.
Yeah,
gave he it got to on him. Bottom lip.
It's weird.
I know. That's what I said. And not only that, he like messed with it because his like it looks way worse than mine, and he like in one day.
Did he get medicine for that?
Ooh,
there's
there
Loverboy.
He is.
Come on
yeah,
over here, buddy.
I gave him medicine.
Out there getting in their heads.
You're getting in their heads?
How are you getting in their heads?
Well, she came out there. She was like, the other gal, she's out there freaking out. Like, what if it's spiders?
Mm-hmm.
Or roaches?
Yeah.
Maggots. And she's like, stop!
You're not scared of any of those things?
I'm not going to say one thing or another.
What are you the most scared of?
I'm not telling you anything.
Why?
You
we
know
can't
your
change
mom,
what's in
your
the box
Your mom told
now.
Us, right?
I know she did.
Yeah, she told us. And your worst nightmare's in that box, big boy.
Big boy.
It'll be all right, though.
She's watching, and I...
Where's that?
He has red, Mom. Use a match? What do you mean? You put a match? You put a match on the cold sore?
Oh, my God,
that
no.
That sounds scary.
Will you let
Becky,
me do that
you
to your face?
Real?
Will you let me do that to your face?
Match on my face? Yeah. To my cold sore?
Yeah.
Maybe. I might let you.
It just would sear it.
I might let you do it if I have
Oh,
it
my bad. I thought you could hear him. My bad.
I'm willing to try
on.
Everything. Oh, you didn't?
No. No, I did for us, but not Loverboy.
No.
You want to say anything to your fans, Loverboy, if you got any out there?
You mean she didn't hear me the first time?
That's your only fan? Is your mom?
I know where you sleep at night, so don't be spilling beans.
I don't think mom would ever do that to you, lover boy. Here we go, buddy. Good luck to you.
The Tracy's Collision Cam is live. Search Frog Mornings on YouTube.
One down, two more to go. What's in the box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning live on the Tracy's Collision Cam. We've told you what is in the box. Now it is time for a second contestant to put his hands in there to see if he can figure it out in the fastest time. His name is Loverboy. Loverboy, Johanna, acting like he's tough. You picking up on that? And you know he's scared. I can feel him shaking. His knee's shaking right now.
Yes. He's scared. He's scared. He should be.
You know who should be scared is that third person out there.
Why is that?
I'm getting in her head.
You're getting in the third person's head?
You know, roaches, maggots, spiders.
You say all this, but you don't know what's in the box. You know we have twisted minds, right? You watch this show. Huh? We're
Gary's
crazy.
Gary's the one who wanted to take the bands off that lobster.
That's what I'm saying.
Well,
he's crazy.
Let me tell you something now, lover boy. And I probably shouldn't because we said we're not going to give any hints out. But I feel like we're friends here, so I'm going to tell you. I'm going to let you inside. No, we promised we wouldn't, but I'm going to tell you. That first one, did you look at her fingers at all? Did you look at her fingers?
No.
You didn't see it then?
Is anything they do, it's just trying to get in my head.
She got bit.
For real?
That ain't no joke. She got bit this morning.
If I get bit, I better get superpowers.
Well,
no bad. I don't know. You're wearing a Batman shirt, but I don't know if you're going to be. We need you to do something, lover boy, before you stick your hands in the box, okay? Everybody has got to do a waiver or we can't move forward. All right? So can you raise your right hand, please? Say I. Lover boy.
Lover boy.
Will not sue the radio station.
Will not sue the radio station.
If I get bit.
If I get bit.
Okay. That's all we need.
Just scary.
Everybody say they're going to sue me. It's Johanna's idea.
I have no money. Everybody knows they're going to come after me and get nothing.
Oh, come on now. Lover boy, get ready. What you're going to hear in your headphones is a countdown. 3, 2, 1. When you hear one, you're going to stick your hands inside the box. This is a timed event. So go in aggressively. All right? If you get bit, you get bit. Okay? We got a first aid kit here. We'll take care of you. When you think you know what it is, yell it out. But what we actually prefer is even when you're touching it for the first time, whatever it feels like, just say it. Okay, so it doesn't have to, you don't have to wait until you know what it is. Just as you're feeling it fumbling around, if it feels like something, say it, and you may stumble across the answer and not even know it, all right? You understand the rules?
Oh, yeah.
Are you ready to play?
Let's go.
He is scared.
I think he's scared.
He is scared. Time to play What's in the Box.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Get him inside, lover boy. Get him inside. Get him inside.
Down. There you go. There you go. Oh.
That was dentures, isn't it?
Time.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes, that's correct.
Did you forget?
Oh, my God.
My mother's a dental assistant.
That doesn't mean you feel dentures
all
day.
Why are you feeling your dentures? That don't make sense. You say, Mom, bring your dentures home so I can feel them?
Like, that is the most recognizable thing out there, you know.
Dentures?
Dentures? You are speaking to a very niche crowd. No, that is not the most recognizable thing out
there. And did you know that those are RIP? Those are from a dead person. Those are real dentures that they donated to the radio station.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Please don't doubt it because it is real. Your name is Mary. Thank you, Mary, for your teeth. That's an incredible time of
9 seconds.
I don't know that that's going to be beat, lover boy. Congratulations. You're in the leaderboard right now. Don't tell anybody else your score when you go into the other room, though, okay?
Oh, yeah.
When we come back, the final contestant will be sticking her hands in the box. This is What's in the Box with John Henry's next.
Wake myself, wake myself for the sun of the morning.
Jerry and Johanna in the morning.
It's the most recognizable thing.
Did you forget? I didn't know your mom was a dental assistant.
Well, I went there. Remember? She helped me out when I had the wisdom teeth problems.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
What does the winner get?
We have concert tickets.
Concert tickets.
Actually, all of them are going to win. They don't know it yet.
They don't know it yet. I mean, listen, I've never felt dangerous in my life, and neither has Dane. And Grandpa Cindy works at a dental office. It's not a normal thing to feel dangerous.
How can you feel? How can you feel dangerous? Because the first thing you feel are the gums.
Like, that's so crazy. I feel like they're really, everybody's really good at this. It's kind of disappointing. I need some more guesses.
Will you stick your hands in there and act like you don't know and see if you can feel?
Yes.
I don't want to touch them.
It's okay.
I don't want to touch
They've been washed.
You were in a bag that still said the lady's name. It feels like tea.
It does. Can you put it upside down? Now, that's not so much teeth, right?
Yeah. Once you pick it up, you know. Is that back in the middle?
Yeah. Once you pick it up, you know.
I think so.
Damn it. I thought it was going to be a tough one, too. Well... I was surprised by that.
Or do they know since they all watched the show and probably saw last week's show, Gary?
What's that have to do with dentures?
Did we say? No, we didn't.
No. We have Mary's last name. We just want to out of respect.
Out of respect. Yeah.
Out of her family. Oh, my God. Why'd I come in today?
Are you kidding me? Is that bad?
You obviously have never had popped ribs.
I think I have. I think it's so cute that you're going to a sports doctor.
Why? It's a sports injury.
You need like a recreational doctor.
Oh.
I got hurt playing recreational jiu-jitsu.
You said they would all win, Gary. Last week I did.
Oh, we did? Oh, my gosh. Everybody remembers stuff I don't even remember.
Yeah, we need to stop. I do have short-term memory loss. We have to stop giving away stuff to people for participating.
I know. Can't help it, though.
Maybe we should have put that other one in there. Do you have the other set? Are they over there?
You can't now.
No, I know. Just to show everybody. We could have went... We just went over the real dentures instead of...
Because, like, what are we supposed to say? Just teeth with this one? We could have left it open.
But I think if you feel the metal part, you're going to be way thrown off.
Yeah. Because you don't want it to be too hard.
Mm-mm.
I don't know, though. I think you'd know. Feel.
Yeah, I think you still know.
I know. Put your hand back in.
The wrap is helping a little bit, guys. Thanks for caring. Appreciate it.
I wish this was harder. There's a lot of spaces in this guy's mouth. Is that like perfect teeth of what they want you to have? Do you know I used to have a gap?
Where, in the middle?
Mm-hmm, when I was a kid. No. I miss it. Kind of wish I had a gap still. Gaps are cool. It's totally not a gap anymore. Yes, I would.
Teeth can make or break you.
I think a gap would make you look model-esque. Because it's like a unique, weird thing, you know?
Well, if the gap's not in the middle and it's not centered.
Well, then no. That would be not cool.
Oh, my God. Okay. Hey, after this, let me see here. After this, we have awards, evidently. Yeah, Kyle's in trouble with the show for sure.
Donald, today's your birthday? Happy birthday, Donald!
You know what we should do for Kyle?
What?
We should actually, as punishment, make him do his job. We should make him book a show.
We have to make him book the whole show, and then we'll call all the people we booked and tell them not to show up.
Oh, my God, yeah.
That's what we should do. We are salty.
Thanks, David. Yeah, I can't let it go.
I know, you can't.
I just did us wrong, man. Hey, Ken, can you go get the gang?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks, buddy.
I feel so short. Why am I so short?
Well, you kind of are.
No, I'm not.
I think so.
See, Allie says small front tooth gaps are cute. Johanna, my boyfriend has one. It's adorable. See, I think so too. I love it.
Small one, yeah. Small one, yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't talking about some mega huge gap.
Oh.
There she is. Yes,
come on over here. Ah. You can bring the other two in too. They'll just stand on the side over here. How you doing, Nicole?
How are you doing?
I'm like shaky. I'm nervous.
It's pretty traumatic. It's pretty traumatic. Hey, guys. Sorry again. You can just stand over here. We're going to reveal the results of the game here in just a second after Nicole goes.
Listen to your favorite morning show on the Tracy's Collision Cam.
Every morning.
Just head over to Facebook. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
What's in the box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning? Becky has gone, Lover Boy has gone, and now we're down to Nicole. She's going to stick her hands inside the box to try to figure out what it is in the fastest time. She does, she's going to win a concert ticket. She's nervous. If you're looking on the cam, you can see the nerves in her face. Probably doesn't help that when she was in the back, both Lover Boy and Becky, we told them not to say anything, but I think that they accidentally did with the way they were acting. Is that right, Nicole? You got to get close to that microphone.
Yeah, get close
too.
To the mic.
Oh, my God. Okay.
What were they doing back there?
Hey, Becky over here was doing like deep breathing exercises, mm-hmm. and then he put a jacket over his face and
Lover
went
boy,
mute.
Yeah, and he didn't say anything, huh? Are you worried about sticking your hands in this?
Yes.
You are. What do you hope is not in there?
I don't want anything alive.
You don't want anything alive. And if it were to be alive, and if it were alive,
I don't know.
Will you still touch it?
No.
How are you going to know unless you touch it?
How are you going to know? You got to touch it to find out if it's alive or not.
I'll poke it.
Poke it? Well, the problem here, Nicole, is that you have 60 seconds. So you got to get in there. You know what I mean? And just touch it.
Full force.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
No. There is something we have to tell you, and I'd rather girlfriend to girlfriend. Can you tell her the concern about her sticking her hands in there?
We're supposed to have waivers to sign.
Yes, I heard that.
Yeah. So we don't have them. So we're going to have to do a verbal waiver, if that's okay. So I just need you to raise your right hand.
Raise your right hand.
Say it. I, Nicole. Swear. To not sue the radio station. If I get bit.
Oh, my God.
You got to say it.
If I get bit.
Amen.
Because there is a chance you could get bit, Nicole. I just want you to know that. For real. Can you please pull the microphone a little closer to your face? All right, just grab and pull it. Because you got to, can you still stick your hands inside with the microphone where it is? Okay, I think we're all set. We're okay. Are you ready to play the game?
I guess.
60 seconds on the clock. This is What's in the Box. The fastest time is going to win concert tickets. And it's time to play. When it gets to one, stick your hands inside, okay?
Two, one. Go.
Get him inside. She's slow.
Go down.
Oh, you just touched it. What does it feel like?
Ew, it feels like teeth. Like,
feels like...
like dentures.
Dentures.
There we go.
Time. It was dentures. That wasn't so bad, was it, Nicole?
No.
It gets worse. They're from a dead person.
No, they're not.
Yes, yes they are, actually.
Are they really?
Yeah.
They actually are.
Yeah, those are Mary's teeth.
R.I.P. Mary.
Yeah.
We don't know when they took them out.
Stop.
We
before
really
they
don't.
Buried her.
We don't know.
Well, they probably had her. They probably had them in for the services, I would think, wouldn't they?
Why? The mouth is closed. Have you ever seen someone's mouth open at a funeral?
They're not smiling. No. They're not smiling.
Oh, my gosh. No.
Mary, what, you tell me Mary wouldn't smile with that with those teeth? I think she'd be smiling the entire time.
The gums are off kilter. The teeth look nice, but the gums are wrong.
Okay, why don't you guys, Becky and Loverboy, just kind of crowd Nicole. Go stand behind her so everybody can see on the Tracy's Collision Cam. We will tell you this. Johanna has the scores, but I will tell you, all three of you figured out that it was dentures.
Yes, which we weren't sure if that was going to happen. So, pretty impressed.
Yeah, you by far were the most scared, Nicole.
Well, can you blame me?
Okay, coming in third place, Johanna, with a time of...
Okay, so Nicole and Becky both said teeth at 20 seconds, but dentures was the winning... name.
We're looking for dentures, yeah.
And Becky came in third at 24 seconds with dentures.
So third place for Becky. Second place
is Nicole with 21 seconds for dentures. And this is insanity. And I'm a little scared you knew so quickly. But Loverboy came in first place with 9 seconds.
He said it was the most recognizable thing. The most recognizable thing on the planet was these dentures. That's what he was telling us.
He said, of course I know. Dentures, oh, easy.
So thank you all three for coming in. Loverboy, you are first place, and you are going to that Lauren Elena concert.
Woo!
As well as the other two, Nicole and Becky. We have concert tickets for you guys
all
as well.
All of you. Yay!
Yeah. And we always offer this up. Does anybody want the teeth? Loverboy smiling.
Loverboy, he's like winking.
I think you have enough of those at home, probably, Loverboy. All right, guys, thanks for coming in. That was What's in the Box with John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning. Oh,
yeah. Gary and Johanna in the morning.
Sing in the morning.
Oh, my ribs.
Anybody? Oh. Grab them,
pull them out.
I don't know if they're
the
name. Okay. They're really from, like, literally, we, her name was on them.
And the, you, where are the other ones? Stick them in. Oh, my
gosh,
she stuck them in.
Becky!
Oh, my gosh!
She just stuck them teeth in. Oh, Loverboy. Loverboy. You going to put them in?
Those are
no.
Just...
Especially not now.
I cannot believe you just did that. That literally makes me
Johanna
wouldn't
even touch him.
I was having a hard time touching him. Oh, my ribs. You just put those things in your mouth. I cannot believe that.
That pen doesn't work well. This one, yeah, you can use that one and then a marker or something. You do what?
I do hair for a living.
You eat hair? You get hair in your mouth? Do you really? Yeah, the hair splinters would be disgusting. Uh-huh. So just fill out the highlighted area. That's all you need. And they'll be emailed to you. They're digital tickets.
Oh, my gosh. That was hilarious.
Wow. I wish, if I would have known you'd done that, we'd have done that on the air.
I feel like now I need to really give you a bonus prize. Might have an extra car wash around here.
Thank you. Thanks for coming in.
Well, I was just trying them on because it might be a few years and I'll be needing them.
No.
And then your phones are over here, too.
If I ever have to have dentures, I'm going to... Gary will probably be dead by then, so I'll just take his teeth.
You want these big old teeth?
Yeah, I think it'd be comical.
You want these big old teeth in your mouth?
They're really nice teeth.
In, so.
Mary's bag?
Yeah, Mary's bag, so then you don't have to touch
them. Don't say her name, but.
Isn't it comical? Okay. So these will be emailed to you guys. Okay. The tickets will be emailed to you, so be looking for an email from us. All right. Thanks for coming in.
We'll see you.
Nice
to meet
you in
person. Have a good day.
Yeah.
Enjoy the outing out in the town, Becky.
Oh, well, I've got
a lot to do.
See you, lover boy. Take care, bud.
Oh, you have to go all the way back.
Oh, my God.
Nice. Oh, well.
Good luck.
It'll be fun.
The gala. Come on out.
Sounds
like a blast.
See you, Becky.
We'll see you later. I cannot believe she stuck those in her mouth.
That really made me sick. I had to like think of something else.
You did? What'd you think of?
I can't tell you.
What?
It's a secret.
Good job, Ken.
Becky, are you going to tell Dave?
With what? No.
Why was your phone dying? You're like me, Kenny.
Oh, it just went to low battery. That's what happened.
Oh.
But it killed the video.
Oh. It was fine. Perfect timing, yeah.
You would have been fired, man.
No
I'm
way.
Just kidding. No way.
You're our number one guy now, Kenny. He says, no, it's all right. Great job,
Kenny.
Feel
like we really need to up the stakes.
I do too.
Next week, I think we should do mine.
No,
and you have to do it.
No.
Just to give
do
a break.
It to a listener.
Yeah, we just need a break. No, it's not funny for a listener. It's funny for you.
Oh, I have an idea.
Do you? Is it good? That's good. I like it.
Uh-huh.
I like it.
I thought this one, not dissing on their contestants because they did wonderful, but I thought our idea was going to be a little bit, you know, better in my head and the way it played.
I know.
Meeting with Kyle, Gary, do you want me to punch him in the balls for you? Yeah. You tell him he's done for, man. We don't need him anymore. We got Kenny, right, Kenny? Where are you? Right, Kenny?
Absolutely.
Wait a minute. Did I hear him?
I don't know.
Did you say something, Kenny?
Yep. You got.
That's right. Say that's right to Gary.
That's right, Gary.
Well, good luck, Craiger. Hopefully he shows. He's been no-showing quite a bit lately, so you may have to go to the hotel that he's actually staying at to get him. Kenny, did you know that the show was up for some awards?
Yes, I did. After yesterday.
Huh?
After you said
yeah.
It.
Yeah. She put them teeth right in her mouth.
I cannot believe that.
She a fun girl.
That made me ill. I can't. Oh, no. I couldn't even touch them with my hands.
Mm-mm.
Ugh. Ugh.
What would be grosser, her stick them in like that, or if she licks the teeth, or around the gum line?
Licking.
Licking.
Licking for sure. Licking?
Mm-hmm.
They look really clean, though.
Mary took care of them. Why do they put, if you have dentures, maybe you can explain this, why can't you sleep with them in? Will you choke on them? And then why you put them in a glass of water next to the bed?
What?
Why you put them in a glass of water next to the bed?
Yeah, why? Probably to clean up.
Almost
it probably
out.
Has cleaner in it.
No, I think Grandma just did a glass of water.
Rot lost his appetite.
That's rot, huh?
Yes. He's from Cambodia.
Does he live there now?
He's my people. I probably shouldn't say that.
Yeah. Why? It's okay to say.
I lived there for a little while.
Guys, behind-the-scenes talk here.
They soak them to clean them.
We have been nominated for some ACMs we're going to talk about here in a minute. It's still hard to believe.
Is it?
Yeah.
Contact this guy.
Hey. People sleep in them, Sierra says.
Can you hear me?
Sierra!
Yeah. What's up, Kenny?
Craig's in the waiting room.
Bring him on.
What?
Craiger.
Craiger's in the waiting room?
Yeah.
Get him on. Is he in Nashville right now?
Yeah. I don't want to talk about it on the air, radio, because we've beat it to death. Kyle doesn't deserve any more radio time.
No more. There he is.
Oh, hold on.
There he is. Craiger, where are you, man?
Just went past through St. Louis. We're about almost 4 hours out of Nashville.
This is what's amazing to me. He heard this. Craig heard the show yesterday and realized that Kyle no-showed us, and he said, this is BS. I'm driving there right now. I'm getting in my car, and I'm going to Nashville.
Me and my boy Mark just got in the car here.
That's right. Got to hold him accountable.
Got Laura in the back seat. She's sleeping.
Oh, she knocked out, ain't she?
She's out cold.
Yeah. So you got about 4 more hours?
Yep.
And then what's the plans when you get to Nashville?
Tonight we'll hit Broadway, do a couple bars and whatnot, and then tomorrow we're going to the Stadium Series hockey game.
Oh,
they
nice.
Play two teams that play outdoors. They play at Nissan Stadium where the Tennessee Titans play.
Oh, no way. That would be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Is this for your birthday?
No, it just kind of happened to be on the same weekend. We actually planned this about 5 months ago.
Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you're supposed to talk to Kyle, right?
Yeah, he told me when I got to town to hit him up, so we're going to see where he's at. We're going to meet up, and I'm going to give him some hell for screwing you guys over yesterday.
Now, you understand, if he ghosted us, there may be a chance that he ghosts you.
True story.
Yeah.
But he did tell me where he was going to be, so. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just like he told us at 7:20 a.m., he's going to be at his hotel, and he was not.
He's probably staying somewhere under a fake name, so I can't find him.
Oh, yeah, No, he's wearing his name badge around Nashville, I guarantee it. But what? I mean, I just can't even believe it, Craiger. I cannot believe this dude ghosted us. Can you believe that?
I'm telling you, he got hammered up with all those other people.
Yeah.
And he did not hear his phone. I guarantee
it. No, but okay. Maybe there could be like some grace and forgiveness in that, but then just not replying to us at all.
Nothing.
He hasn't called you guys back at all since then.
No.
No.
It changes it a little bit, doesn't it?
And whole another level.
Yeah.
And think of this. You know us. You know us, me and Gary, right?
Right.
You're not good people to spite.
Don't spite us.
No.
You're not good people to spite.
I wouldn't say you hold grudges, except for that you do hold grudges.
Yeah.
Like, we semi hold grudges until it gets righted, and he's not righting no wrongs.
No, you gotta keep blasting until he comes back.
Here's part of the problem, Craig. His job as a part-time producer is to do bookings, which he does none. The dude does not book anything, right? If he were to book something for the show, he would understand how bad it is when somebody no-shows.
You get a no-show,
but he doesn't know that because he doesn't do any bookings like he's supposed to.
No, I do them.
Yeah.
I just did one right now.
That's right.
Yeah. Thanks. No, you've been on fire, Johanna. You've been dialing it in, definitely.
Isn't she good? She's much better, isn't she?
Don't say that.
Yeah. Oh, much prettier, too. True story.
No, Johanna's a blast. Right. She's doing well. What's say something about she dirtier?
Yeah, I'm 30.
Oh, dirty 30s, yeah. That's right. She having a good time, she said lately.
Yeah, I am. I admit. I have a fun life. What do you want?
So, Johanna, how's Dane doing?
He's tired.
Wore out. Yeah, wore out, man.
Oh, he's good. I gave him a cold sore. That's for real.
Oh, no.
Not the bottom lip. They ain't attractive on the bottom. I kind of like the toppers better.
Where is it on the bottom? In the crevice over in the corner?
Right
up front.
Oh, but here's the thing. The bottom lip makes it look more like a zit and not like so much like a cold sore.
Would you rather have a husband with a zit on his lip or with a cold sore?
The zit, for sure.
I guess, but it means he's not clean.
No, it doesn't. People get zizzing. Doesn't mean
it also means he's not transferable.
That's true.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. I just can't believe you're shedding it right now, the virus, and you're just willy-nilly giving it out to people.
I guess. If I have to have it, we all have to have it.
And you get a herpes. And you get a herpes.
That's right.
You get
herpes for everybody.
She'll give it to
you. It's not that bad, guys.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Well, for real, give him a hard time and really sell it. I mean, don't let him feel like we're jokey with this.
No. You tell him. You say.
You don't think he didn't go back and watch the show at all while he was there?
I don't.
Craig, I don't know that he watches the show when he's in here. Like, I don't think he even pays attention. Half the time, watch him, his head is down. I'm like, are you even here, man? Like, say something or look up.
He really effed up doing this because Gary's going to go off.
I can't let it
exactly
go.
Exactly how he feels.
I can't let it go. We even read that stupid essay that he won on the radio.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Put him in the spotlight, got him on his golden trip, yeah. And then he no-shows you.
Then he no-shows, and then nothing afterwards. And people write on the people are saying on the cam that he has been all over Instagram, and he was yesterday. So he's alive.
He's alive. All right.
He's not kidnapped.
No. No. Well, enjoy your trip, my man. Thank you for checking in.
Yeah, have fun.
Yeah, no problem, guys. We'll
see
you.
Be safe.
Bye, Craiger.
All right, bud.
Bye.
We'll see you, man. I like old Craiger. He good people, as they would say.
Me too. He has good people.
He good people, for sure.
Deb, I'll for sure tell Dan you said hi.
Deb Golf?
Mm-hmm.
Man, I tell you what, Dan has got a following.
He's popular.
He should be. He's a popular guy.
He's more fun than me now.
No, I know him to be fun.
I used to be way more fun, huh?
I know him to be fun. Whenever I see him, he's fun.
I know. I'm saying he's way more fun than me now.
Oh, I thought you said he's way more fun than
you. Back
now.
In the day, I used to be more fun than him, and for some reason, our roles changed.
Yeah, actually, you didn't know all those details we just told you? I bet Penthouse would have Kyle's back, though. I bet you're probably right.
Probably.
They're probably like, quit talking about him.
No.
He used to be valuable around here. I'm so glad that he can now be our morning show producer so he gets off early.
You really are pulling out all the stops.
Like, the best of. These are the best of hits.
This is all of it. You're letting it all hang out. Let it all hang out. Don't you cross old Garrett Bear. We got a pop rib.
Don't
I tell
cross
you what.
Me. I tell you what. Tell him. Tell him what.
Tell all the secrets. All the ways he really feels. All the things he's been keeping hidden in depths of his ribs are popping out.
So I keep tally about people. And Kenny, you know how many tallies I got on you?
Zero tallies.
Zero.
Maybe one.
Nope. I don't think I have any on him.
You have one.
What? Can I tell? I got to tell a story about Kenny yesterday.
No. Oh, okay.
No, it's funny.
Okay.
I don't know if Kenny will find it funny. Kenny, can I tell the story?
Sure.
Okay. So yesterday we had a little after 8 o'clock. The video went down on the camera.
Mm-hmm.
Gone.
Yeah.
We don't know why. Everybody's panicking, right? Kenny pulls me aside and he goes, listen, this may sound a little crazy.
It was.
He said,
let's not talk about it.
But do you think it has anything to do with the Russian invasion of Ukraine? Like Russia shut down our Facebook video.
That means he thinks highly of us.
He's highly intelligent is what he is.
He's super smart, but also don't you think like if he thinks that they would care about shutting
right?
our stuff down?
I know. That's the love that we need from a producer.
That's what we need.
You know what I mean?
Kenny, you're in big trouble because now we're falling in love with you.
Oh, you better start doing bad stuff.
You better start wronging us.
I don't think he can. Would you ever wrong us?
No, never.
He never would wrong us.
Never wrong us.
Love it. See, I feel like Kyle always wants his face in here on the camera. Kenny don't want it.
No, he doesn't.
Kyle?
You think he wants his face on the camera?
Yes.
I don't think he does.
Yes. Why are you defending him all of a sudden?
I'm not. I'm making
You better pick sides right now and draw a line in the sand.
You listen to me. I'm about speaking facts.
He wronged us both.
Just because he wronged us doesn't mean we have to be liars. I'm not going to lie about something. I'll say straight facts. And there's enough facts that he's in trouble with us for. Fact one, he said yes to 720 booking. Did he show up? No.
You don't think that he wants to have his face on this camera? When he said the other day something about us trying to replace him.
I'll be honest with you with that. Yeah. I did not catch that.
You didn't catch that one?
No. But also, think about it. The chair he's in is the most ugliest chair.
He don't care, but that shows you the desire to be on the camera. You're willing to sit in that ugly chair. You're right. I'm surprised he ain't fixed it. That lighting is terrible. Apologize to the guests. I got to sit in that.
Remember when I used to pump and have to turn my camera off?
Yeah, and we'd hear...
I can't believe that didn't bother you more than... Or you didn't say...
I didn't
say.
Care. Why would I care?
Because you were, like, picky about sounds.
I get used to it, though. It's like my waves at night when I sleep.
Did it become soothing? Like
I think they should have that as a setting.
Well, it brings me back to when Joanna used to pump her breast
Yeah, put me right to sleep.
Put me right to sleep.
Oh, man.
That's funny. Oh, my gosh.
I hear you.
No more animosity. Just let it be.
I didn't even bring that up, though.
Okay.
What?
Double, triple, and down on stuff.
What do you mean?
Just.
You gotta just let it go.
You need. I'm telling you to.
What I'm saying is, Craig reignited the fire. I let it go.
Yeah. Okay. 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 I'm here.
That was on Craiger, unless you scheduled that.
Wait, when is Craig?
You did, didn't you? You booked that.
I booked that. That's how good I am at booking. I knew you were going to talk about it at that time. I said, last night. And I said, Craig, can we have you on?
What are you going to say? We got to talk.
I don't know. Just okay. Let's talk.
Facebook.com/Froggy981.
Now, this was a surprise. We've been told that we were up for some awards, and the show has actually won some awards.
It's about time, you know? I've been around how long, and I've just been dying to, like, have something cool like this happen to us.
Yeah. It's the ACMs. It's not the CMAs, which this show has been nominated for Personality of the Year. We lost. But we were a finalist for it. ACMs, though, it's like a cousin to it. You know what I mean? Like a less attractive cousin, but you're still like, oh, okay, she's kind of hot. Which is weird to say about your cousin, but you recognize it still. There's a girl in the building. Her name is Brooke Summers. She works in the afternoon. She has not been here long, and she is killing it. I've been here for 20 years, ain't won nothing. She's been here for a couple months, and she's up for, like, New Faces of the Year or something in country radio. And I don't know if I'm right on this. I think they're flying her to Vegas.
Yeah, we didn't ever really ask that because we weren't sure if she was doing it via Zoom or not.
Right. I think they're flying her to Vegas. She is the voice, the girl in the afternoon. She is the voice of the ACMs. And she works at this radio station.
Yeah, that's so crazy. That's a huge, huge deal.
Yeah. And she could have an attitude about it, but she doesn't. She's like the sweetest person ever, isn't she?
Yes.
So sweet, she told us inside info, and she's not supposed to tell us.
I know, I'm so excited to find out.
Shows up for awards. She said, this is all I know. And what she told me is she's going to announce those coming up here in about 10 minutes or so, or less, on the air. All I know is that you've won a couple of ACMs.
I did?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, you've won a couple. And this pains me to say, Kyle won an award. For what? I don't know yet. I don't even know the category. But you cleaned house. I think that you've won the most awards out of anybody.
I did?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think
I
won.
Get a trophy. Do I get a trophy? I need a shelf in here.
I don't know if you get a trophy. Yeah, they give trophies out, but I don't know if they do for these. I don't know. I don't know if these are verbal awards,
Have you ever gotten an award like this before?
I just told you, no, I did not.
No, never in your life? Never in your radio career?
In radio?
That's what I mean. Like, in radio, have you ever, like, gotten an award like this?
I got the runner-up for CMA Personality of the Year. I didn't get nothing for that.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
No? Football, yeah, I got all kinds of.
No, I don't.
Radio, no. I'm lucky to have a job. I don't know how I've been doing this for 20 years. Are you kidding me? There's your award. So we had to time this up right because she said that Brooke is going to do her ACM voice work for us. So she's going to actually present the award with the dramatic music behind, just like when you watch the ACMs. We're all going to be able to witness that. And you're going to be able to hear why she was selected to be the voice of the ACMs.
Yeah.
While giving us awards. You have to be really proud of yourself. You just got full-time at the radio station.
Yeah.
And you're taking home the hardware. I can't believe it.
I can't believe it either. I don't even know what to say. I feel like crying.
Do you want
to
do? We can do that. Because she did tell me that you did win awards for real. That means you got to do acceptance speech on spot.
Oh.
If you feel it.
Okay.
If you feel it, okay?
Okay.
What awards did the show win? We will share that with you with Brooke Summers, again, the voice of the ACMs, next.
Wake up. Gary and Johanna in the morning.
My morning show rocks.
Weekday mornings from 6 to 9 on Froggy.
I think Gary's probably one of the best ever in radio. He could be somewhere much cooler.
Not as good as my brother. That's what my mom
said. That's true. I've never met your brother.
You met my mom.
I have met your mom. She seems like an
awesome Y'all got a good laugh on that, just the visuals.
No, the
she had a hard life, man.
Maybe
she had a hard life.
I think your mom was fine. You know what? She said, my favorite thing she said is she said that you did kiss your sister.
No, she said I wanted to.
Yeah, she said you wanted to.
I liked it. No, she said I liked it. Laughing. Cruel, man. It's just cruel. Can't get your mom to. And she was in the front seat and didn't even remember me having to kiss my sister.
She said you wanted it.
Yeah, she said I wanted it. Yeah.
So clearly she remembers part of it.
That's right. I do get credit for finding Joanne on Talent Search. Yeah, found her. Nasty old nails and all. Lost, confused. I said, follow me.
I was not lost or confused. I just had nasty nails and was just learning how to work at a jewelry store.
Yeah, my birthday, guys. 4343 O Street. That's the address.
God, please send something.
For Monday.
Listen, if you guys don't send gifts, we might not have anything for Gary's birthday.
That's not true. You've been planning something. I've caught you in a couple conversations.
Oh, my gosh. You haven't caught me in nothing. Listen, I had to do a birthday by myself just recently, and now you're going to make me do it again.
That one was BS.
Regardless, I had to do it. So that's what I'm saying. You haven't had to do anything except for mine.
Tara doesn't know the story. Tara, I went to the jewelry store one day, and I saw this girl. She had nasty fingernails. They're all chipped and everything. Showing fancy jewelry to me and made fun. I'm like, oh, look at my nail. And I'm like, this girl is funny. She got personality. She don't even care what she looks like on the fingers. Everything else looks good.
What she looks like. This nasty old girl, she'd be great for radio. No one will see her.
Yeah. So even my wife and I did that. She goes, you got to get her for radio. I said, yeah, you're right. So I went down and I did some intel work. Couldn't find her no more. Now, where the hell is this girl? And then I got her number. Somehow I called her and left voicemail messages and didn't hear nothing for months. Mm-hmm. Then she finally checked her messages and called back and then got her on the air. She slept for 2 years.
No.
Woke up and this is what you get.
Listen, I didn't sleep for 6 months. I was bored AF. You guys don't understand. When I first started working here, they were old and boring and doing really boring stuff.
I've gotten older, Johanna.
Admit it. You are way more fun now than when I first started working here.
You woke me up.
You were not fun at all. When I first started working here, you were super duper boring.
Okay. Well, let's blame the other person who used to work in here. He was boring AF.
You both were super boring old men. And this is the thing they said to me. This is a super fun job, and we're going to be best friends and hang out and do all this stuff. First concert I go with these old men, they leave the second they can leave. They didn't even stay for any parts of the concert.
He's in sales now, Lazy. Yeah, because I had to guess I'm a professional. I had to get up next day for the show. You're a party girl. You're like, let's see you. We're going to see you. Peace. And see her next day wearing the same clothes, smelling like alcohol.
No, I did. Yes, okay. I will admit there were a few of those days.
And I said, this is a party girl. Let's keep her. Those were days, man. She would take shots to wake up.
Good times. Those were fun times because then I could go home and take a nap before I had to go to my second job. Now I have to go home and keep children alive.
Yeah, no, it's different. Yeah, he didn't want anybody to know that part, Lazy.
What? What part? What part?
Sales tale one.
Thank you, Cindy. That's a really nice call.
What's Cindy say?
She said, I make this morning show worth watching, listening to.
Absolutely, without a doubt. It would be terrible without her. I quit. I think I quit.
That's really nice of you to say. That makes me powerful without being powerful.
You do have power. No, you have power.
I know, but it makes me powerful without being powerful. You know what I mean? It's like this odd thing. It's nice. I like it.
Becky,
I was going to take a shot before I stuck my hand in the box. Amar, you're going to write a poem for Gary. Don't tell him.
You already did. Too late.
Oh, Amar, okay. You got to send me a rough draft, though. I got to hear what it hears like. What?
That made no sense.
No. Someone to... Oh.
How long do I have to find a date for that? Oh, well, Loverboy need to find a date.
Loverboy, you ain't gonna take your mama who taught you what dentures feel like.
All right, about showtime. I'm struggling, Lacey. Thanks for asking. But you know what? Show comes first.
You are really in pain.
Don't even try now. You don't care. You ain't carried on 2 days.
I was going to be mean, and then I was like, no, be nice. Be caregiver.
You're not a caregiver.
No, I guess I'm not.
You're a giver for sure. Ain't no care to it.
Tracy's Collision Cam is live. Search Frog Mornings on YouTube.
Academy of Country Music Awards. It's a big one. Brooke, who works at the radio station in the afternoon, she's the voice of the ACMs. When you watch the show, which I think is on Amazon Prime or something, isn't it? When you watch the show, you're going to hear a voice that sounds familiar, and that is Brooke, who works at this radio station. We believe they're flying her out there. She did the show a solid. We thought that she was the only one getting anything out of this.
Yeah, no one told me I was up for anything.
Yeah, she told me that you're a multiple award winner. ACMs, I can't even believe it. I'm so proud of you. You should be proud of yourself. I don't even know what the category is or what you've won yet.
Now I'm scared.
Why?
I don't know.
You shouldn't be.
There should not be. This is the thing. There should not be multiple things that I'm winning.
Well, you have won multiples. What worries me is she said Kyle won an award. Kyle.
For this show?
How did he win anything?
Like specifically within this show?
Yeah. For something on this show. I think the voice of the ACMs, Brooke, is ready to reveal the category and the awards this morning. You ready for the first one?
Yeah.
And the winner for the most cold sore flare-ups in a two-week span is...
Gary!
Johanna!
No!
From Froggy 98.
No! That is no!
Oh, my gosh. For cold sore flare-ups, too?
Yeah. Just because I had two in the span of 2 weeks. Here's the thing. You want me to thank someone? I thank you and your chewed gum that I chewed secondhand. And that's how why I have cold sores to this day.
No. I wasn't shedding them.
Listen, I'll take the award. I have had a lot of cold sores for real.
A lot. And now she's handing them down to her husband. He got one on the lower lip.
I'm spreading the virus.
The next award is for, it looks like I'm hearing that this is possibly a producer award, I believe.
I don't even want to hear this one.
I believe this is a producer award.
And the winner for worst producer of the year is Kyle from Froggy 98.
Surprise.
That
like
is the
usual,
most accurate.
Kyle didn't connect to Zoom to accept this award.
Oh, she said he was supposed to connect to Zoom, but he didn't.
As usual.
Surprise. He picked up the hardware for the worst producer of the year. Out of all of those qualified candidates, he won. It's incredible. He should be proud of himself.
Did you win an award?
Ow!
Oh my gosh.
Oh my God, my ribs popped. Hang on 1 second. Yeah. Yeah, we weren't clever enough to write in a rib one, I don't think. Let's see what this award is for.
And the winner for biggest boobs is...
Me.
Gary.
Yes.
From Froggy 98.
That's BS.
Biggest boobs. Biggest boobs where? In the building? I got the biggest ones?
You might have the biggest boobs. Yeah.
People are going to think they're floppy boobs. They're not pancake ones or nothing.
No. You can move them.
I think that you may have picked up an award for this category, which you're going to be really, really happy about. I have some inside info on this one.
Okay.
Are you ready to celebrate?
Yeah.
The next award for...
And the winner for hottest girl in the building goes to...
Me.
Brooke Summers from Froggy 98. I'd like to thank Johanna's cold sore for this award.
Oh.
Cold
it's
sore.
It's almost gone, man. Dang it. When do they look for these awards? I haven't had a cold sore that long.
Oh, that was a joke. This is the real one. You really did. There was one award that the morning show did win. ACMs. You'll see that on Amazon Prime. I don't know if this is going to make it on TV or not. Are you ready for the real award that you won?
Is this actually real or not?
This is a real one.
No, it's not. Yeah, what is
I'm so proud of you.
And the winner for the hottest girl with a ganglion cyst is Johanna from Froggy 98.
Gary and Johanna in the morning. Sun.
Gets me through my morning every day.
On Froggy 98. Sure.
No. God, my ribs popping during that terrible timing.
That was so funny. And the winner for the hottest girl, Brooke Summers. She's begged me. Oh, that was so funny.
Oh.
I would say that the most accurate award out of all of those was Kyle's.
Without a doubt. Without a doubt.
You do have big boobs. Show the cam.
There they are.
Can you move them or is it going to hurt your ribs? Don't do it. I actually probably want to do it.
I can still bounce them.
I don't know if I would. I don't really want to deal with the flopping. Oh, okay.
Still bounce them. It didn't hurt the ribs.
Oh, you got to wear the jammy shirt and do it. I can't wait to get our pictures back. I thought we were supposed to get them today.
Yeah, we are. I don't want to see them.
I'm scared, too.
This is what this is about. I was told I looked good in a shirt until I took the pictures, and I realized it was a joke on me.
Did you go back and watch the videos? Do you know how many people said to wear the green shirt?
Joanna, I don't even want to freaking
hear it. You decided in your mind that you wouldn't.
Go back and watch the footage. Oh, yeah. It's got to be that one. It's got to be that one. That's what you both said.
I never said that.
Yes, you did. I look like I'm wearing pajama top.
No.
It's so embarrassing. No. Yeah, it is.
You do not look like you're wearing a pajama top. I don't know why. What about it? You think it looks like a jam top because it's tight?
Yeah, it's tight. It's pajama material. It's from like the buckle or something. From
it's
a nice
pajama
place.
Material.
It feels like it. I hurt my ribs doing jujitsu. For those of you asking, I see a couple on here.
It's really annoying. I mean.
I'm starting to sweat under there.
Probably. I hope they can fix you.
Oh, hey, Kenny, can you rate that last bit for us? How'd that sound?
That sounded pretty good.
Sound okay?
Yeah.
Sounded
really good.
Okay. It's not hard hitting, you know, like Kayla Ann does. Probably not used to this.
I messed up, though.
When you talked over the...
Yes.
Yeah, just
I'm
one
sorry.
Time. Just one time.
I'm sorry.
Gary, we can fam mostly said go green. Becca, I did not see it. I listened to these two. We're supposed to be my friends. Now I know I got one friend, not another one. Not him.
Oh, I'm... this coffee is really bad today.
Is it?
It's really bad. You should go get some. And just taste it so you know.
We get best up by a 6-5-year-old, LOL.
A 6-year-old.
Oh, he get beat up.
Gary, we camp fam mostly said go green. Yes, I told him that. I said go green. I said I like go green. I don't even want to tell you all the ins and outs of it all, but I will one day. And this is the thing, I said go green.
You have way too many of those. One days. When's the day come?
I don't know.
Do you know how many one days you mean?
Listen, I like having like things up on you.
But you forget.
Listen to me. Can I just say one thing to you?
What?
And this would shut you up for real if I could for real tell you.
Yeah.
You had a secret from me for a very long time. So I don't want to hear it.
No, it's not a secret.
Yes, it was. How was that not secret?
Because I legally was
I
not
aware
supposed to say anything. You know that now. Do you
no,
not?
I don't.
You don't? And the paperwork that you saw, what was the language within it?
No lawyer.
Legally.
No lawyer explained it to me, so I don't know.
I would be in breach. Okay. Now what you got to say?
No. Because as a friend, you still could have told me.
Am I supposed to break the law for you?
Yes. Absolutely. Real friends break the law for each other, I think. Anybody here break the law for your best friend? I would. I'd break the law for you any day.
Or I could go to jail.
Ask me a law. You could not go to jail for that. You would not go to jail for that. There's no way.
Johanna.
I'll break the law for you right now.
What would you do?
I'd jaywalk for sure.
Oh, my God. Such a good friend. Ribs take 6 to 8 weeks. I can't do that. It's going to get me behind on my next stripe. What's embarrassing is I have a dinner tonight with two other couples, and I got to go there with these ribs. Yeah, she makes you 100%. Are you typing over there?
No. How could you tell?
Leave me stranded over here.
My brother-in-law, Jeremy, said that was so funny. And I gave you credit. I told him you wrote those.
It's team effort. Oh.
You talked realtor to me?
No. He says because it's contract talk.
Remember that one time when I was going to be your assistant in realtor talk, in realtor world?
Yeah. Got to get business first.
Like me personally, I need to get you business. I have.
I'd be like, there ain't nothing to do today.
I thought you... Oh, you need business. I'll get you business, but then I'd be mad because you'd be making all the money off of me getting the sales.
Yeah, you got me business.
I did get you business. I got you business. What? I'll get you more business.
Yeah.
No,
not. But why would I?
Because we're friends. You said you would break the law for me, but now...
But I won't make
you... But now you won't give me business?
I'll break the law. Don't you think if I'm giving you money, I want to cut?
Can you leave that door open? It's hot.
Do I get a commission cut?
Commission, that is, again,
illegal. Do I get a commission cut?
Per the Nebraska Real Estate Commission, you cannot get commission.
Break the law for a friend.
I can pay you an hourly wage. You're used to that.
Yeah, I am.
Not anymore.
Not anymore. I'm big time.
Well, this is what I'm excited about. Well, yeah. What you got?
What is that?
This was dropped off for you yesterday.
Wait.
For Gary.
For your birthday on Monday.
Oh, my God.
He said you are not supposed to open it till Monday.
No, he can't. We have to make a show for Monday, so that's a break.
So, but she wanted to remain anonymous.
Okay, don't tell me anymore. We're going to call you and you give us this info, okay? We'll get you on the air in a minute. We need a break.
Oh, in a minute. Okay, we'll call you in a minute. Hey, okay. Are you going to do my break?
What?
I
got you down.
Okay.
I got you down. We have a couple breaks left.
Okay.
We can do this one last.
I don't care.
I don't care either.
Yeah, we have two breaks left. I'm just going to talk to you about this regardless because you might have did me wrong.
Okay, perfect. I've missed the show early this week and then... What? What are they saying?
I'm just wondering why we're missing someone that we're not missing.
Oh, yeah.
Gary, are they bruised or dislocated?
Dislocated. They got what you call popped ribs.
They are bruised. It's just a little bruising.
Are you surprised, Kenny, how tough I am? How I just tough this out?
Yeah. Oh, I'm not surprised.
You're not surprised. Yeah. He thought that was a trick question.
Kenny,
he didn't know how to answer it first.
Really quick. Kenny, for real, though, do you think it's like the pain he's displaying is merited? Like, you think he actually is in pain, or is he being a baby?
Oh, I imagine a rib is... You know, that's pretty painful.
Wait,
pretty
but
painful.
You imagine or you know?
I don't know.
See? He doesn't know.
But he's heard. Now imagine, cracked rib, bruised rib, that's bad. Imagine going in and out, in and out, in and out. And it pops every time. Pop, 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 pop.
I haven't heard it pop once. I haven't felt it pop once. So I just cannot attest to any of that being accurate information.
Doctors aren't going to do anything. Thanks, Stacy.
I love our listeners.
Oh, my God.
They're my favorite people in the whole world.
I'm not going to a chiro, man, for a rib problem. I'm sorry. They can't pop this rib back in place. That don't even make sense. This guy got loose cartilage or something. Exit Recon missed the show yesterday. I thought we were missing something.
Okay, does anybody know a chiropractor that would zoom in and show me how to pop him back in?
You can't. It's so tender. You don't even understand. It hurts so bad.
Would you let me do it if a chiropractor zoomed in and showed me how to do it?
No, because somebody said here they pop the back to make the front work. That doesn't even make any sense.
What do you mean?
How are you? You cannot pop the rib in. Chiropractor don't pop ribs in.
Yours was out more than the other one. I feel like if I just push really hard.
You want to do hook technique? No.
I did not. No. Do I want to? Yes. But would I know?
You started to curl your fingers. I felt over the ridge. Creep over the ridge. I did. I had to yank you back.
Yeah.
You're cruel like that.
I just wanted to see how bad it
you're like,
hurt.
No, I didn't know.
Well, I just wanted to see how bad it actually hurt.
Ow. Oh, I just did it again.
Seriously?
That was a mini. I know. That was a mini one. I'm hoping the doctor says
walk on his back.
continue to work.
My chiropractor put my ribs in all the time. Nicole, why are you getting ribs out all the time?
Jamie, what? Don't say that. Now I'm making me think I gotta go chiro.
They popped it back and relieved a ton of pain.
But you're talking about, Jamie, are you talking about it was a popped rib?
What do you think they would say? See, someone on the cam, April said, what if we called them?
How do we know that these aren't all chiros trying to get work? All these people saying go to chiro.
Well, I'll say this. I'll say you could have a lifelong customer right now, but you got to prove yourself. Tell me right now, walk me step by step what I should do to fix this man.
Maybe. It may be something there. People have told me, they stopped me on the street and said, boy, you sure have done a lot for Johanna.
And no, I said,
I said, well, I appreciate that. We told stories on the Tracy's collision cam. Sorry, my rib was starting to pop out. about how I found her and how, you know, she went from just a part-time employee to now a full-time employee at the radio station.
That is impressive for you, I will say. Because that, from what I've heard, what happened for me doesn't happen very often for people.
No, so you were, I saw you were a shiny object, but dull at the same time. Like, I got to clean this thing up, and I think there's something there, you know what I mean? So, ended up working out for you. 5 years later, here you are, you're a star. Everybody, you get recognized, you're now full-time here at the radio station. Things are really working out for you, so it pains me. Even more than my popped rib that goes in and out constantly during the show, where you seem not to care about. It pains me when I hear you say something about, and I just caught me doing you wrong.
I think you wronged me. I think you did me wrong.
You think I did you wrong?
I might have done myself wrong.
Okay.
I don't know who did the most wrong here.
I'll admit to it if I did you wrong, and I've done you wrong before. I'll say that.
Either you gave me poor instructions or I'm just that bad. Okay.
Is it driving instructions? Because then that's all on you.
No, that's for sure. I'll admit that to the ends of the earth. I'm a terrible driver.
What is it about?
So I've been wanting to make myself lunch every day.
Oh, don't you dare get me. Don't you dare. This is my salmon recipe.
Listen, if anybody, I know you don't like the TikTok talk, but people do like it. And there is this salmon recipe thing that typically is made with, like, this girl makes it and it's with leftover rice and salmon, and you, like, mix it all together and make it. It's almost like an undone sushi type thing.
Okay.
I've been craving it. I've been wanting it. So I bought all the ingredients. My good friend Gary tells me, this is idiot proof.
I did.
Literally said idiot proof that I would have to be an idiot to screw up the salmon.
I did. I said that. And you'll never eat restaurant salmon again after you have this.
Yes. And I told my husband about it, which he was offended first. God. He was first offended that I was taking cooking lessons from you.
Oh, why? Because he does it. Does he smoke it on the grill? It's not even necessary with this method, this three-step method that anybody can do.
Okay. But also, like, this is tells you how my husband has no faith in my cooking skills, like, at all. Because I don't cook, ever. But I think I just feel like I should have been able to do it, especially with your tips.
So easy. Kay? Did you try?
First of all, my first problem was he got me skin on salmon.
You said skinless.
I know, but he bought me skin on salmon. So that,
it's more expensive. I mean, it's cheaper, that's why. He's scared he's going to get in trouble.
And the salmon was too big. So I did not know I was going to have to cut the salmon and cut the skin off.
Cutting the skin off of salmon is disgusting. It's slimy. I can't even get in. It's brown underneath it.
It was like ruining the meal for me, so I just couldn't do it. So I just said, we're leaving. So the salmon skin
was... You left
was,
the skin on?
Well, half on.
Johanna, that's not part of the instructions. It doesn't work like that.
Okay, well, I did it. I did it, and I did your... But I did an extra...
Oh, my God. Did you please tell me you didn't just cook the skin?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I cooked the skin, but I gave it one more minute on that skin side because I felt like it needed to penetrate through.
Oh, my God.
So I did 5 minutes on the skin side.
My ribs. My rib is going to pop out. My rib is going to pop out.
Listen, I did the Gary foolproof method. Oh, my God.
Go ahead, it popped. Go ahead.
4 minutes on the other side.
Yes.
And I ate it. It wasn't bad. It was pretty good. It was like you said, it was crispy and stuff, okay?
Yeah.
But I was up last night sick.
From your salmon. From the salmon. You probably ate some skin.
I
Did you eat the salmon skin?
Are you not supposed to eat the skin at all? No, for real. You're actually not supposed to eat the skin?
No, you can't. I don't think you're supposed to.
Shut up.
Johanna, for real, did you eat the skin?
I may have had some bites because I couldn't get all the way off.
Gary and Johanna in the morning. Can't wake up without weekday mornings from 6 to 9 on Froggy 98. You're listening to Froggy 98. Check us out while you're out of town or away from your car on our free Froggy 98 app. Available on your smartphone.
Feeling that you think I'm faking it.
I do feel like
Oh, my God.
I feel like you just don't look like you're in real pain.
That shows you how tough I am.
Mm-mm. It shows you that you want sympathy.
Somebody says you can eat the skin. She ain't no bear, no Kodiak.
I'm not kidding you. I was sick. My stomach hurt so bad last night. I was like sick. I kept waking up with stomach aches.
Did you get sick?
Like I felt like I was going to vomit.
Did you?
I didn't actually ever vomit. However, I had a lot of burps. That was like.
Did you have problems on
burps.
The other end?
No.
So you weren't sick.
Yeah, but my tummy, you know when your tummy is rolling.
Oh, let me tell you guys the salmon recipe quick.
No, listen to my experience. I got sick.
Why didn't you can cut the skin off pretty easily, actually. You just...
No, I tried. Dane told me, hold the one in and do that. No, you cannot cut the skin off pretty easily. It's really hard to cut the skin off.
Go get yourself. Let me just tell everybody quick. It's the best salmon you'll ever have. It's easy. Idiot-proof, some will say. Get yourself center cut salmon, not the thin one. It's got to be skinless on both sides. It'll save you a ton of time. It's a thin slice, but thick. You know what I mean? All you need is salt and pepper and olive oil and a skillet, medium high. That's it. Get the skillet nice and hot. Salt, pepper, both sides of the salmon. Put a little bit of olive oil on one side. That side that you put the
olive oil on both sides.
I told you one side.
I
you
did
put it on the skin. So take the part that has the olive oil, put it that side down, set your timer for 4 minutes, do not touch it. 4 minutes up, flip it over, another 4 minutes, take it off. It's done. It'll be the best salmon you ever eat. What Johanna went wrong, she had skin, she oiled the skin side, she ate the skin. Cooked it too long, probably tough.
The crispies on top was nice. It was a nice touch.
On the one side? Oh, my God.
It smelled.
It does smell. Do you guys have a fan?
Becca, he did call me idiot.
You guys have an exhaust fan?
I don't know how to make it work.
Here, I got to hear this one again.
And the winner for worst producer of the year is Kyle from Froggy 98. Like usual, Kyle didn't connect to Zoom to accept this award.
You know why I talked over that? Because you put a big old gap there.
There was a gap in there.
Why did you put such a big gap?
I don't know. I don't remember. I don't know if that one is my favorite or this one was really good and low out.
And the winner for the hottest girl... With a ganglion cyst is...
This is you Johanna know, it's such a from BS. Froggy 98. Mine is not diagnosed. My ganglion cyst is not diagnosed. My husband doesn't think it's ganglion cyst.
What's he going to say? Of course he's not going to say it's a
no,
ganglion.
No, he's saying bunion, which I think sounds worse.
That's probably less attractive.
Would you rather
date a girl, Kenny, with a girl that's got a bunion or a ganglion cyst on her foot?
That's tough.
Yep.
That's tough as
everything else
don't
is
want
the same.
To do either one of them.
Everything else is the same, but one foot... She got ganglion, the other side is a bunion. Which one is less attractive?
I think the bunion is less attractive.
Yeah. Right? See, I told
than
you.
Than a ganglion.
That's what I
is
said.
Is it the word bunion is
bunion
less attractive than ganglion?
Gross.
Like gangly ganglion?
Yeah, that sounds pretty bad.
But bunion sounds gross, too.
Which one's worse, though, Kenny?
I think the bunion is worse.
Why is bunion worse? In my head, it sounds worse, too, but why?
Because
bunion.
It shouldn't be on your lip, bunion. Right?
Bunion, no, bunions are on feet. But they're usually
on Kenny is giving me extra ailments. He's talking about my lip.
Bunion is on the side of the foot, typically, I think. Have you seen her try to squeeze her feet in these
shoes?
Look
how skinny you look. Stand up.
Who?
Show everybody how skinny. You look really thin.
That'd prove it again. It's because of this thing.
It looks better when you see it all the way up. But for like for in this view right here, I got a screenshot it. Look how skinny you look.
You screen save it.
Yeah. Mm.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm going to get out of shape fast. I can't lift. I can't jitsu. And then what happens? Everything just goes to hell. Last night, Kenny, I ate DeLeon's for lunch. Should not have. I ate out last night. Probably going to do it again. Yeah, it's like a corset, Allie. That's
why do you say that so not right?
Corset?
Corset. That's what you've been saying. Corset.
That's what it is, a corset.
It's a corset.
What's that word you can't say?
A lot of them.
What's the one?
You know what the one that you really made fun of me for? I bet you don't even remember.
There was a recent one that you couldn't say.
Sure.
Yeah, that's what it is. You have a good memory.
Remember Wolf? I had to practice that after I met you.
Why, what were you saying? I can't remember.
I don't want to tell you.
Wolf?
Mm-hmm.
Say wolf.
Wolf. I still say wolf. It's a wolf.
That's better.
A wolf?
A wolf.
A wolf.
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 A wolf.
The Tracy's Collision Cam is live. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
Cool and Dre.
I'm going to make a guess, so I don't know for sure, but this is just a guess. Is it Monday when I come in here?
Oh.
There's going to be probably balloons everywhere. My guess is probably a red carpet leading into the studio, maybe even out into the parking lot. You may put a sign up, VIP, for my birthday, give myself my own parking spot. It's already begun. I think the mind games with this, you're making me think like you've put zero thought into my birthday, which is Monday.
I put zero thought into your birthday, which is Monday.
You're really selling that. You're really selling that. And what I think what I just witnessed a few moments ago was part of the master plan. You told front desk Amy, you gave her my first present.
No,
and you
I
said,
did not.
Come into the studio and pretend like it's from a listener and with instructions not to open it until Monday.
Yeah.
Hoping that am I going to buy into the fact that you've thought zero about this?
Totally. Can I open that gift first and then you open it?
Whatever. What is in it? It's like a little treasure chest or something that you gave Amy to give to me already.
Yeah. Listen,
that's not from you,
chest,
you say?
Treasure chest? No, that's too much thought. Ask Amy straight up.
I'm going to ask her straight up.
Thank you for calling Broadcast House. This is Amy. How may I direct your call?
Direct it to yourself, Amy.
Hi, guys. Happy Friday.
Thank you. You know, my birthday is on Monday, Amy. Have you put that up yet on all the TVs in the building?
No.
When does that go up?
Well, I don't usually do that for birthdays, but...
But you're going to make an exception, you say?
Maybe.
You have to put his age, though.
Don't worry about the age.
You have to put his age.
Listen, now, we need to get down to something here. Johanna's trying to take credit for the gift that you brought in here.
Mm-hmm.
Did she give that to you to give to me and say, don't pretend like it's from a listener?
No, it's not from Johanna.
It is not from just surprise.
No.
I would never fake that. No, he's a liar. I'm trying to convince him that I haven't done anything for his birthday, and he thinks otherwise.
You know that she's going to do something special for me, right, Amy?
Oh, I'm sure she will.
Yeah, she's known for that.
I'm not known for that.
Yeah, you are. You told me you go all out for birthdays. That's what you told me, all out for birthdays.
I go all out for my own birthday.
No. So somebody, what's up with this gift that somebody brought in? What are the instructions with it?
Okay, well, she dropped it off late yesterday, and she said you are absolutely not supposed to open that until Monday on your birthday.
Okay.
Okay, and she wanted to remain anonymous, but yet she also said she'd like to meet you guys sometime, so, yeah. So I told her she should come in earlier in the morning, and maybe she can get a picture with you, but
is this?
We'll see. I don't know if she'll do that.
That's all
do
she
you
said.
Know... If this is someone who has given us anonymous gifts in the past?
I don't think she has, but she didn't say.
Because remember, we have that one anonymous person who gave us the cups with our faces on it.
Oh, yeah.
Remember,
gave
me my birthday gift with the rabbit basket.
I have to be honest. I don't understand the anonymous deal. Why don't you want credit?
Yeah, I know.
Why don't you want credit? Here it is on the cam. If you're on the cam, you can see it.
Because some people, unlike us, are like actually humble.
I would want credit for sure. I want them to say my name, bring me on the cam, the whole deal.
Yep. Yep.
All right. Well, we'll open that on Monday. What a surprise. I wasn't expecting anybody to do anything. That's so nice of whoever that.
The good. Keep that expectation, please.
No, no, no. Not listeners. I'm from you, I expect a lot. Amy, thank you. You have a great day, okay?
You're welcome, you too.
And thank you for watching and for listening this morning. If you missed any of the show, it's all recorded. You can go back and catch it on Facebook, Froggy981, on YouTube, Frog Mornings. And then we've got this, we're on the Nebraska Now channel, Roku, Fire Stick, and Apple TV. You can catch the show there as well. We hope on Monday to have that announcement for you for our next Froghead Beer location. We're hoping we can reveal that coming up on Monday. So have a nice weekend. Hang on, Jason and Dean. We'll start a bunch of music next.
Gary and Johanna in the morning.
It's the only morning.
Okay, Kenny, you can go ahead and click the button.
Goodbye. See y'all. Bye. Farewell. I'll be the same.